Okay, students, welcome to online chemistry classes. States of matter lesson already started. It is lecture second. Students, in states of matter previous video I have told you that three states of matter are there: solid, liquid, gas. Out of that, solid state we are going to see in second PUC. Liquid state is entirely deleted from your syllabus this year, and so left is only gaseous state. And let us start with gaseous state. Now student, before seeing the important properties of gaseous state, let us see which gases are there in the periodic table. Periodic table in detail you have already studied. So where are gases in periodic table? So you will be knowing that first period hydrogen gas. Second element, helium, that is also gas. First period over. First period is shortest period having only two element, both are gases. Second period, which gas is there? So in second period, here you can see that boron, carbon, after that nitrogen is gas, oxygen is gas, fluorine is gas, neon, argon, krypton, xenon, radon, here chlorine, like this. Total 11 gases are there in the periodic table. Out of that, these 6 are noble gases. Okay, and remaining 5, like this, total 11 gases you can see in the periodic table. Okay, already you know the important properties of gases. Let us have a quick view on the important properties of gases. Of course, you know that gases neither have definite shape nor have definite volume. Okay, then gases always occupy the entire space made available to them. Okay, how much space will be made available to them? All that space gases will occupy. Okay, liquids, how much liquid quantity is there? That much only it will occupy the space. But gases occupy entire space. For example, see, if one agarbatti, take example of an agarbatti, will burn that agarbatti in a small box, closed box, that fumes will remain in that closed wooden box only. If we will burn that agarbatti in a room, then what will happen? That fumes will occupy complete entire room. Okay, smell will go everywhere, fragrance will go everywhere. If you will burn this agarbatti in our classroom, very big classroom, then it will occupy the entire classroom, all corners. Means what? Gases always occupy the entire volume made available to them. Okay. Next, gases are highly compressible because we know that gas molecules are far away from each other. So we can compress them. Unlike solids and liquids, solids we cannot compress, not at all. Why? Because solids already arrangement of atoms is how very compact. Between the molecules space is very less, voids. Okay, that are called as voids. Space is very less between the molecules. That's why we cannot compress solids. Liquids we can compress a bit less. But gases are highly compressible because much more empty space is present in between the molecules of gases, so we can highly compress the gases. So we can say that gases are highly compressible also, gases are highly expandable also. the entire space they will occupy means they are highly expandable also. Okay, so see the properties, neither finite shape nor volume occupy the entire volume made available to it. Then gases are randomly moving, always movement will be shown, thermal energy. Okay, so gases are continuously moving, and while moving they will collide on each other. Also they will collide on the walls of the container. Imagine that gas is there in a closed container. Then what happens? While it is randomly moving, it is colliding on each other also. It will collide on the walls of the container also. And whenever it will collide, that time it will exert pressure. Okay? When it collides, gas molecule will collide on the wall, then it will exert pressure. Okay? So pressure is exerted by gas molecules. And exert pressure. Okay? Here point I have written, gases are highly compressible and highly expandable also. Next point, gases mix evenly in all directions. Do you agree? Yes. For example, just now I have told the example of agarbatti burning. Smell will, that fumes will mix everywhere in all directions. It's not that in only one direction fumes are going. If you will pass nearby a bakery, the smell comes to you. Okay, everywhere the gases has a tendency that gases mix evenly in all directions. Okay, without any mechanical aid. Mechanical aid means any external source for mixing is not required. Okay, without mechanical aid, gases will mix together. Okay, and this property, what I have written, gases mix evenly without any mechanical aid. Mechanical aid means external source for mixing, like fan or something, not required. Okay, without any help, gases will mix into each other. This property of gases is called as diffusion property. Okay, this is called as gases. Gases are having diffusion nature. Okay, diffusion property. Next property, of course, gases are having low boiling point and low melting point as compared to solids and liquid. Why? Because boiling point, melting point depends upon the bonds present. And we know that as compared to solids, liquids, gases are having weak bonds in between the molecules. And that's why boiling and melting point will be low in case of gases as compared to solids and liquids. Last property we'll see, gases are having low density. Of course, students, what is formula for density? I have written gases are have low density. What is formula for density? Density is equal to mass divided by volume. Everybody will be knowing this formula, is it? Now see, density is directly proportional to mass. Gases far away from each other, so mass will be less only. Then density is inversely proportional to volume. Gases occupy entire volume, so gases are having much more volume. Inverse relation is there, so how much more volume, that much density will be less. Okay, so like this, gases shows various properties. Let us move to the important topic, various gas laws. Yes, friends. Now let us start with the gas laws. Important topic started. Students, lesson states of matter is a very small lesson. Hardly within 6 classes it will be over. Okay? Because liquid state completely syllabus is deleted. So only gaseous state is there. We have to study only gaseous state in detail. Okay? So hardly 6-7 classes are required and lesson will be over. So whatever, that day's work, that day only finish. As soon as you will see the video, immediately first watch the video properly, secondly again watch and make your notes. Okay, and keep reading. Okay, So let us start with the gas laws. Gas laws are very important. In this lesson, we are going to see four gas laws. Okay, I will arrange these four gas laws in order to make you remember. Okay, we'll see the gas laws in the order A, B, C. Okay, A, B, C. Avogadro's law, Boyle's law, Charles' law, and of course fourth will be the G, that is Gay-Lussac's law. Okay, so let us start with Avogadro's law. Already students, Avogadro's law is taught to you in first lesson only, but still we will repeat this. Okay, because this is required in further derivations also. So what is Avogadro's law? Avogadro's law states that, okay, so to understand Avogadro's law, you have to imagine one thing. Okay, let us imagine I am having one balloon. Okay, filled with, imagine, hydrogen gas. Okay, balloon is there, hydrogen gas is filled in that balloon. Inside inside the balloon, hydrogen gas, 100 molecules are present. Hydrogen gas, 100 molecules are present. 100 molecules of hydrogen gas are present. Now imagine that I am having one more balloon, having same volume. Okay, I told you that, see, I am in one hand, I am having one balloon in which hydrogen gas is filled. And total molecules of hydrogen gas here are 100 molecules inside the balloon. If in another hand I am holding another balloon in which oxygen gas is filled, then volume, I told, volume is same. Both are having same volumes. If I will ask you how many molecules of oxygen will be there inside, then answer must be 100. If volume is same, inside molecules will also remain same only. If outside volume is same, then inside molecule number is also always same, provided temperature and pressure is constant. For all gas laws, keep temperature and pressure constant, because you know that gases get affected by temperature and pressure. Okay. So, what is Avogadro's law? Equal volume of gases always contain equal number of molecule. Equal volume always contain equal number of molecules. This is Avogadro's law. It states that student, when I am teaching that time only keep on remembering the gas laws. Today all four gas laws I will tell. All four, at the end of this video you should be remembering these four laws. Okay, that, like that, concentrate. It states that equal volume of gases contain equal number of molecules. Of course, at constant temperature and pressure. Provided temperature and pressure is kept constant. Okay. So what I told, always for Avogadro's law, remember example of a balloon. If their volumes are same, if here 7 molecules are there, here also molecules will be 7. If volume is same, inside molecules will also be same. Equal volume of gases always contain equal number of molecules at constant temperature and pressure. Okay, so we can show that volume is directly proportional to L. I will write K. Where, what is K? Of course, K is proportionality constant. And student, what is N? N means number of moles. Okay, one mole contains Avogadro's number of molecules. one mole always contain Avogadro's number of molecules. Okay, so volume is directly proportional to N. N means number of moles. Okay, so this is Avogadro's law. Let us move towards A is over. Let us move towards B, that is Boyle's law. I'm putting a star because very important type of law. Boyle's law gives relationship between pressure and volume of gas. What the Boyle's law states? First see mathematical equation and then let us state the law afterwards. Okay, I will write only it states that. I will tell you one method by which you can remember all the laws. Okay, so Boyle's law I'm writing like this, see students. Pressure is inversely proportional to volume. Of course, at constant. Now, student, what is constant? Boyle's law gives relationship between pressure and volume. Okay. So, what is not here? Pressure is written, volume is written. What not written? Temperature. So, I am writing temperature constant. Also, I am writing at constant N. Here also, N indicates that number of moles of that gas are fixed. Okay, fixed amount of gas is there. N constant means number of moles of that gas are constant. That is, a fixed amount of gas is there. Okay, understand the way how I am writing Boyle's law. What is Boyle's law stating? Boyle's law states that pressure of a gas is inversely proportional to volume, of course at constant temperature. But I must mention N also. N means what? Fixed amount of gas. N is constant. Number of moles of a gas are constant. Means gas is a fixed amount of gas. So I will add here now. Pressure of a fixed amount of gas is inversely proportional to volume at constant temperature. Okay, all next laws we are going to write like this only. Okay, I am going to teach you four laws: A, B, C, G. Avogadro's law, Boyle's law, C, Charles' law, G, Gay-Lussac's law. In all these four laws, we'll see temperature, number of moles, pressure and volume, four parameters. Volume, pressure, temperature, number of moles. These four parameters. Okay. Okay. Here also you can see for Avogadro's, we have seen volume, number of moles and what was constant here? At constant temperature and pressure. So, here also parameters were 4, here also parameters are 4. Out of these 4 laws, whatever I am going to teach you today, the only Boyle's law is inversely proportional. All other laws are directly proportional. Okay. So, see what, how can you write Boyle's law? See here, pressure of a fixed amount of gas is inversely proportional to volume at constant temperature. Okay. So, I will write. It states that pressure of a fixed amount of gas is inversely proportional to volume, is inversely proportional to volume at constant temperature. Only law which is inversely proportional is Boyle's law. So I have written P is inversely proportional to volume. Inversely proportional means you should write inverse, means 1 by that term. Okay. Let us, I don't want this proportionality sign. Let us remove it and put it equal to sign. So what I will write, see students, here P is equal to, I will write K into 1 by V. Where what is K? Where K is proportionality constant. K is proportionality constant. So I can tell that PV, V is here for division, it will go other side, it will go for multiplication. PV is equal to K, that is PV is equal to constant K. So what is mathematical equation for Boyle's law? Mathematical equation, P is inversely proportional to V, or you can say PV is equal to constant. PV is, V will go here, PV is equal to constant, or you can say PV is equal to constant. So P1 V1 is equal to P2 V2 is equal to constant. Gone understand students? Or what you can say, see here, P1 P2 I will take down is equal to, what is here, V2 V1 I will take down. So these are various mathematical forms of Boyle's law. Things are clear? See all mathematical forms. Whenever Boyle's law is asked, immediately also derive mathematical form for Boyle's law. So mathematical form is P is inversely proportional to V also, P V is equal to constant also, P1 V1 is equal to P2 V2 also, P1 by P2 is equal to V2 by V1 also. Okay? So let us see now graph for Boyle's law. How to plot the graph for Boyle's law? Now see students, graph should be pressure versus volume. What is relationship between pressure and volume? Inverse relation is there. I hope that you know any graph for inverse relationship will be always like this. Okay, see here, for inverse relation, graphs are like this, always, if relationship is inverse. And for direct relationship, graphs are straight line, if relationship is direct. Do you agree with this? Why? See here, okay, this parameter is high, at the same time this parameter is low, inverse relationship. Direct proportional means it is going up also, it is going along this axis also. Both parameters are increasing. So always remember students, whenever you have to draw the graphs, that time for inverse follow this graph, and for direct relationship graphs should be a straight line. Now let us plot the graph for Boyle's law. We can see that relationship is inverse. Who is inversely proportional to each other? Pressure and volume. So what type of graph I am drawing? See students, here I will draw a graph, pressure versus volume. Can you see now? See here, inverse relationship. Here I am showing pressure is highest. At this point, pressure is highest. Volume is low. Here see, pressure, okay, we will see this point. Pressure is low, but here volume is high. So, this is the graph for inverse relationship. Okay? Now, this graph is plotted at what constant temperature? So, this graph I will call as isotherm. For this graph, I will call as isotherm. What is isotherm, students? Isotherm is the graph plotted at constant temperature. Iso means same, constant. Therm means temperature. Graph plotted at constant temperature is called as isotherm. Okay, so the relationship was inverse between pressure and volume. Can anybody guess here in Boyle's law who is directly proportional to each other? Directly proportional to each other. So you can see that pressure is inversely proportional to volume, but pressure is directly proportional to 1 by volume. Pressure is directly proportional to 1 by volume. So that also graph you can plot, try to understand. If I want to plot a graph for direct relationship, pressure is directly proportional to 1 by volume, and that's why graph will become like this straight line. Always I have told you that for inverse relationship graph should be like this, and for direct relationship graph should be a straight line. So that here inverse, who is inversely proportional? Pressure and volume. Who is directly proportional to each other? Pressure and 1 by volume are directly proportional to each other. This graph is also called as isotherm. Why? Because it is also plotted at constant temperature. Okay. So this was all about Boyle's law. It's mathematical form. So all these are mathematical forms. All these are various mathematical forms of Boyle's law and various graphs for Boyle's law. Students, let us move towards Charles' law. Yes, students, next law is Charles' law. Third law. Okay, so I hope you are remembering the laws. Four laws I am going to teach you. A, B, C, Avogadro, Boyle's, Charles. Charles' law. In all these four laws, four parameters we will see. Pressure, temperature, volume and number of moles. Okay, number of moles are constant, meaning is gas is of fixed amount. Okay, let us start with Charles' law. And among four laws, I have already told you that only one law, Boyle's law, is inversely proportional. Yes, Charles' law, it states that students, see first mathematical form and accordingly we will write the statement. Charles law is V is directly proportional to T. V is directly proportional to T. Okay. So, of course, at constant will come what? At constant, V and T, volume and temperature is there. Means what is constant? Pressure and N. So, how can you define Charles' law or how can you state Charles' law? Volume, N is constant, means volume of a fixed amount of gas is directly proportional to its temperature at constant pressure. Okay, it says that volume of a fixed amount of gas is directly proportional to the temperature is directly proportional to the absolute temperature here. Absolute temperature of course at constant pressure. I hope you understood the method or the way you should state the law. Okay, statement should be complete only. Okay, so volume of a fixed amount of gas is directly proportional to absolute temperature at constant pressure. Student, here you must use the word for temperature as absolute temperature. So what is meaning of absolute temperature? See, absolute temperature, note down students there, absolute temperature scale, that is Kelvin temperature scale. Absolute means Kelvin temperature scale. Okay, so you know that temperature can be expressed in degree Celsius, degree Kelvin, degree Fahrenheit, various ways are there. Absolute temperature is temperature in Kelvin temperature scale. Now, for degree Celsius and Kelvin, what is difference, students? Remember, whenever you will write degree Celsius, that thing compulsory you should write like this. Celsius means that number raised to degree and then Celsius. For Kelvin, you should not put degree, directly Kelvin you should write. Okay, so it will be 100 degree Celsius. Okay, but it will be only 100 Kelvin. Difference understand. For degree Celsius, it should be degree Celsius, and for Kelvin, you should not mention that degree. Okay. These details gone, understanding gone, remembering students. Okay. So, Charles' law you understood. So, let us write the mathematical form for Charles' law. Very easily you can write mathematical form. Students, see here, is directly proportional to T. I don't want this proportionality sign. I will put constant K. Of course, what is K? K is proportionality constant. Next, therefore, V, temperature is for multiplication, it will come for division here. V by T is equal to K, that is equal to constant. So, we can see that V by T is constant. So, we can say V1 by T1 is equal to V2 by T2. Is it, students? V by T is constant. So, we can say that V1 by T1 is equal to V2 by T2. Various ways worth remembering. Only one mathematical form don't remember. For PU, you should not remember this much, minimum, limit, maximum, more and more. Various ways you should go on remembering. So, all these are various ways of mathematical form of Charles' law. Okay. V by T is equal to constant, V1 by T1 is equal to V2 by T2, or S you can also write like V1, V2 will come here, T1 will go there. So, even you can write like this. V1 by V2 is equal to T1 by T2. Okay. So, these are various ways by which you can write mathematical form for Charles' law. Okay. Now, students, let us draw the graph. Let us plot the graph for Charles' law. I hope the statement is clear, mathematical form is clear, and let us draw the graph. Now, for plotting the graph, I must take volume and temperature. I will take volume here on this axis and temperature. Now, I will express in other axis, but here temperature I will mention in degree Celsius. Okay. Now, student, actually, in our statement, it is absolute temperature. Absolute temperature is Kelvin scale. Kelvin and degree Celsius, how related to each other? I hope you remember the relationship, how to convert degree Celsius into Kelvin. In degree Celsius, if you will add 273.15. I hope you remember this. Degree Celsius, whenever you will add 273.15, then it will get converted into Kelvin. Okay. So, here, if graph has degree Celsius here, I can't take immediately here 0 degree Celsius because it is absolute temperature, means Kelvin scale is there, 0 Kelvin I should start with. But here I have written degree Celsius, so you tell me 0 Kelvin means how many degree Celsius? I want to write 0 Kelvin. 0 Kelvin means how many degree Celsius? So of course 0 Kelvin means minus 273.15. degree Celsius. So I will start here temperature from minus 300, minus 200, and here comes one point directly proportional to graph will be a straight line. Okay, this is at constant pressure and this temperature is what, student? This point. This particular temperature from where straight line goes is minus 273.15 degree Celsius. That is 0 Kelvin. Kelvin scale it is 0 Kelvin. Okay. This point is called as absolute zero. What is absolute zero? In detail we will see. Before that, let us finish this graph. Graph will be, of course, directly proportional to graph will be a straight line. This graph is at constant pressure, so it is called as isobar. Okay, so what is isobar? Graph plotted at constant pressure is called as isobar. Okay. I hope the things are very clear to you students. Charles law understand. Remember VT, V directly proportional to T. That is Charles law. Mathematical form, graph, everything is clear. Let us see fourth law, that is Gay-Lussac's law. Okay. Fourth law is Gay-Lussac's law. Students, this also write down. Absolute temperature meaning you should know. In Charles law, you must mention that volume is directly proportional to absolute temperature only. Absolute temperature scale means Kelvin temperature scale. Okay. So students, let us see now next law, that is Gay-Lussac's law. Gay-Lussac's law. Exactly similar to Charles law it is. It states that, okay, mathematical form I will tell CS students, P is directly proportional to T. In Gay-Lussac's law, P is directly proportional to T. Yes, you can guess very easily. Of course, what? At constant will be what? At constant, four parameters is different. Pressure is there, temperature is there, miss what is missing? At constant volume and N. Okay. So, how can you state Gay-Lussac's law? The method I told for all laws is same. It will help you to remember all the laws very easily. Pressure of a fixed amount of gas as constant N. N is number of moles. Number of moles of that gas are constant, means gas is of a fixed amount of gas, mass is constant. Pressure of a fixed amount of gas is directly proportional to its temperature at constant volume. Okay, so it states that pressure of a fixed amount of gas, pressure of a fixed amount of gas is directly proportional to temperature at constant volume. At constant volume. Yes, mathematical form, how can you write, student? Similar to this. So, pressure is equal to K into T. K is what? Proportionality constant. K is what? Proportionality constant. So, I can take T is here for multiplication. Here it will come for division. P by T is equal to K is equal to constant. So, how can various ways you can state this? You can write mathematical form of this law is P1 by T1 is equal to P2 by T2, one way. Or else what can you do? You can interchange this and you can write P1 by P2 is equal to T1 by T2. Of course you can do in interchange this also, means T2 by T1 is equal to P2 by P1 is also correct. Okay, so these are various mathematical forms of Gay-Lussac's law. Let us draw its graph. For drawing graph, of course, okay, here for Charles' law, it is compulsory to write absolute temperature. Gay-Lussac's law, you can mention only temperature. Here, pressure is directly proportional to temperature. I am plotting the graph, pressure versus temperature. I am taking now temperature directly. I am writing temperature in Kelvin only. So, our graph will be very easy. Temperature directly I have written in Kelvin. So, direct proportionality means straight line will be there. Directly proportional to graph will be always a straight line. What this graph will be called? Now, this graph is plotted at constant volume. Such graphs are called as isochores. What is isochore? Graph plotted at constant volume is called as isochore. So, this was all about Charles' law and Gay-Lussac's law. Okay. Students, all four laws of gases are over, and combining all these three laws, we are going to see next topic. But before that, let us see some small topics like what is absolute temperature. This is called as absolute zero temperature. Zero Kelvin, this is called as absolute zero temperature. What is definition of that? Let us see. And let us see what is STP. STP is standard temperature and pressure. Let us see that. Yes, students, let us see what is absolute zero temperature. Just now in Charles' law, we have seen absolute zero temperature, that is minus 273.15 degrees Celsius. Okay, that is zero Kelvin, is called as absolute zero temperature. Okay, absolute zero temperature means what? Either zero Kelvin you can say, or zero Kelvin means minus 273.15 degree Celsius. See, student, for Kelvin I am not putting degree, for degree Celsius only I am putting degree. Okay, so how is this? Okay, absolute zero temperature meaning is what? Exact meaning, let us understand. Charles' law states that volume is directly proportional to temperature. Just now we have seen Charles' law, V is directly proportional to T. Volume directly proportional to temperature means what? Temperature increases, volume increases. Temperature decreases, volume also decreases. Now let us do. If temperature is more, volume is more. Temperature decreased, volume decreased. Temperature again decreased, volume again decreased. Like this, as temperature goes on decreasing, volume goes on decreasing. Imagine a gas and its volume is decreasing because temperature is decreasing. Now, when temperature becomes zero, the time volume should also become zero. Volume of the gas should also become zero because at zero Kelvin temperature, very less temperature, volume of the gas also becomes zero. That temperature is called as absolute zero temperature. Means the temperature at which volume of the gas becomes zero is called as absolute zero temperature. So what I told you, students, how temperature decreases, volume also goes on decreasing. Is it volume directly proportional to temperature? Temperature is decreasing, so volume is also decreasing. Finally, temperature becomes zero and volume also becomes zero. Then, generally, think, is it possible? Volume of the gas became zero. What is meaning of that? It means that gas doesn't exist only. How is it? Volume can become less, very less. Because we are seeing that gases are highly compressible. You can compress gases to a lot amount. Okay, highly compressible. But it's not possible that gases will occupy zero volume. Okay, at least some volume surely they should occupy. So this doesn't seems correct, is it? Temperature became zero and volume of gases became zero. It doesn't seems correct. Means it is little imaginary or it is hypothetical. Okay. So what is absolute zero temperature actually, students? Absolute zero temperature is a lowest temperature, that is for sure, because at this temperature volume of the gas should become zero. Actually, volume of the gas should become very less. Okay, so it is lowest temperature. Of course, it is hypothetical or it is imaginary temperature at which gas will occupy zero volume or gas will not occupy any volume. That is called as absolute zero temperature. So how can you define absolute zero temperature, students? It is the lowest hypothetical or imaginary temperature at which gases occupy zero volume. Okay? Imaginary only, because there can't be any such temperature when gases are going to occupy zero volume. No volume only. No volume means gases don't exist only. Actually, it is correct only. See, yesterday in previous video, I have told you that whenever we have to convert gases into liquid, LPG gas, like that, you have to imagine. Gases we have to liquefy, we have to convert gas into liquid, that time what we should do? We should compress one thing, second thing is we have to do cooling. So whenever temperature becomes very less, cooling is done, that time gases automatically will get converted into liquid. So you can easily think that when temperature is 0 Kelvin, that is minus 273 degree Celsius, this much less temperature is there, means very much cooling is done, means gases don't exist only, already gases have been converted into liquid state. Here the important thing is only definition of what is absolute zero temperature. You have to remember the values and concept you understood. Now let us only define what is absolute zero temperature. So what I told you, student, it is the lowest, definition should be very much perfect type of definition should be there, always the lowest hypothetical or imaginary temperature at which gases occupy zero volume. Is called absolute zero. Is called absolute zero, or it is also called as absolute zero temperature. So, student, you should understand that it is lowest temperature, not possible. It is just hypothetical or imaginary, because gases are occupying zero volume means no volume. Its meaning is gases don't exist only. It's not possible. Okay. So, definition remember properly. 1 mark definition will be asked. Let us see what is meaning of STP. Whenever you will be solving problems, that many times they won't mention temperatures and pressures which are required to solve the problem, but there will be mentioned STP, at STP. So what is meaning of STP? Let us see. STP means standard temperature and pressure. Okay, standard temperature and standard pressure. So let us remember the values of standard temperature and pressure. Standard temperature will be, okay, 273.15 Kelvin, and standard pressure is always 1 bar. Okay, standard pressure is always 1 bar. Students, okay, 1 bar means how many Pascal, that also remember. How much possible, go on remembering. 1 bar is always equal to 10 to the power 5 Pascals. Then you will say that, madam, why to remember Pascal? Because Pascal is SI unit. Okay, so you should know the value of pressure in SI unit also. Standard pressure is 1 bar, and 1 bar is equal to 10 raised to 5 Pascals. Okay, now molar volume, gas, how much volume gas occupy at STP? Volume occupied by the gas, volume occupied by 1 mole of gas at STP is called as molar volume. 1 mole of gas, so it is called as molar volume. And its value is always in first lesson only. In stoichiometry topic, you have seen this value as 22.7 liters per mole. 22.7 liters per mole. Okay. So, students, remember what is standard temperature, what is standard pressure. Values keep on remembering. Okay. So, we'll stop today's video here, but in next video we'll meet soon in next video with next topic, ideal gas equation. Keep working, students. Today's work today only finish. No pending work should be there, because lesson is very small. Within very less number of classes this lesson will be over. All the best.